Y'all, real quick, I will be at Anime NYC this upcoming weekend at these panels, so please pull up, say hi, let's hang out, and watch me talk about a lot of different things. Hope to see you there. Okay, bye-bye.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to this conundrum I've brought you all here to talk about here. We're here in the Discord server offering a question. So how about you read that question for us one more time, Mads?
Am I the asshole for telling her to leave because she's not cooking?
Now, that's beautiful.
So yeah, right out the gate, we all have an idea of what we think about this. But
I think this video will get a lot of views. That's what I think.
We're going to elaborate. The Discord is not too happy, understandably so. So, all right. I have been with her for 3 years, and over the past 2 days, she's changed a lot. I work, and she's a stay-at-home wife. I know, it's stupid, but she was very good at it over the last year. Did all the chores and cooked amazing food, so I was fine with it. I make enough and have inheritance for both of us anyways. Now, Friday, I come home to my dirty clothes on the couch. No food for me. She cooked and ate herself. I was surprised at this. I asked her what was all this, and she said she was sick of babying me. I asked her what she meant, and she talked to her friend who talked sense into her. She told my girlfriend that she was raising a man-child and that she was becoming a replacement of my mother to me. Since she does everything, all the household stuff, cooking, cleaning, laundry, etc., and I hardly know how to do that, both completely true, that I was just being a leech and using her as a maid.
You should probably learn.
I was shocked that she believed all this crap, and we had a huge fight. Next morning, nothing changed. We kept fighting, and Saturday evening, I had enough of it.
Uh-oh.
I told her that she would have 10 days to leave the apartment.
Bruh.
She had 10 days to leave the apartment and find herself a place. I told her I wouldn't be her father anymore by paying for everything, and she would have to make arrangements if she was going to continue behaving that way.
Double standard. We thought
she left to her friend's place. Some friends told me I might have been doing a bit too much by kicking her out.
A bit too much?
Am I wrong for this? So what you guys' stances? As of right now, would you say he's in the wrong?
Well,
I think he's definitely in the wrong because, dude, he doesn't even know how to do anything, bro.
They're both going around it the entire wrong way. In terms of,
they're both like just making ultimatums right off the bat without even talking about it.
They need to communicate better.
Yeah, that feels wild. So in general, this feels like the dude's more in the wrong.
I agree.
But just from reading this, because we only get one side of it.
Yeah, right. But on one end, it's his job, I guess, in this situation, if you set up roles for each other, that he brings in the money. And of course, sure, her obligation at home are to help at home. But I don't know, the way he phrased it was like he was...
I think the fact he doesn't even know how to do it.
Yeah, I'm like, bro, which is fine, I guess, but... What was y'all's agreement, though?
Also, it's like,
what was it like from the beginning?
With their dynamic, right? It's like, if they both established that that's how it was, where it's like, yeah, I'm going to do this for you. This is how I work. This is my vibe. I'm not going to work. If that was the case, and then all of a sudden, she was influenced by a friend to be like, wait, my friend isn't doing this, so I shouldn't do it. And then, like, you know, went on strike on that agreement. I don't know. I feel like from his perspective, I get it. Like, if it was no communication and it sort of just fell into that, then she has, like, every right to do that.
What's interesting is the way he says it. Like, he says, I work. She's a stay-at-home wife. I know. It's stupid. Like, he didn't have to add that in.
This is gonna sound nuts. I was almost in his corner because we can have these standards. We can set it where you stay at home and do the house stuff, and I'll go to work and bring in the money. Like, if I stop working one day, that would be a problem. So if you're handling the house stuff, that's your role.
Yeah.
And that's what we've agreed upon.
Yeah.
But one, it looks like he doesn't respect her role.
Yeah.
At all. Apparently, if this is such a problem for you, bro, maybe you should be ordering Uber Eats. I don't know. Her not doing this stuff, sure, that's an issue. But you seemingly treating her like this, just from reading that, this is kind of nuts.
Yeah.
So I'd say both are wrong, but he is really, like, really looking bad here, dog.
Yeah. Just given the fact that he states that he hardly knows how to do cooking, cleaning,
bruh,
and laundry.
How do you not how to, if you never did a
how
dish
you,
stuff?
How are you a grown man and not know how to do the basic stuff, you know?
Bro, it's buttons.
It's not that hard.
It's buttons, bro.
Buttons.
I don't know. I think he's simplifying what she does it might be more of a case where he thinks that only she does those two things, but actually she does a lot more, which he doesn't realize. And it is literally as simple as communication.
Yeah.
This is kind of wild because they've been together for 3 years.
Exactly.
And just in two days, it's so sudden. She feels like she doesn't
Everything happens so quickly.
It's just like, what?
Yeah, like all of a sudden.
There must be something else, you know? I don't think it's just.
Maybe there's some resentment because of the roles
or
something like that. But regardless, if you agree to them, you agree to them. Instead of being passive aggressive, how about we talk about it like real adults?
Exactly. Maybe. Yeah.
It's just kind
of
cringe.
I feel like what happened is she probably had a conversation with one of her friends, and her friend, assuming that her friend had her best interest in heart, maybe her friend was like, he's taking advantage of you, like, you need to reconsider how you're doing this relationship. And she might have felt insecure about the relationship in the beginning, so that might have exacerbated it. So, you know, she might have had a bad day and like threw the clothes on the couch. I'm not saying that's okay, but instead of getting angry with her, the dude should have communicated with her and been like, hey, that's how true. Can I be a better partner? Like, that's what's true. Wrong? Like, let's compromise.
Yeah. Although I can't put 100% blame on him, because I do feel like, one, she should have communicated if she felt a way instead of being angry.
Yeah.
And like, and if that is your role, that is your role. We've both decided on that. But if we have issues with the roles we've set, let's talk about it.
Yeah, they should have just talked about it.
So now I'll elaborate. So there is a slight elaboration on this. Mm-hmm. She takes 3 hours because I said that if she was a stay-at-home wife, I wanted really good food.
What?
The only request I had.
That's expecting too much, man.
Really good.
So it takes her some time to prepare it.
Really good.
The amount of time she takes changes from the food she makes. She has an overall time of chores for 3 to 4 hours is what I meant. Not just cooking for 3 hours. I do take care of her when she is sick.
He makes grilled cheese.
Please don't take care of her when she's sick. No, please. Just like leave her alone. Throw her out when she's sick.
Microwave some freaking chicken noodle soup, bro.
She's sick?
Yeah.
Don't worry, babe. I got you a happy meal.
She's sick? Break up with her.
Sorry, this guy just sucks.
Yo, this dude kind of
He's doing the bare minimum. He's doing the...
You want meals that take 3 hours every night, dog?
3 hours.
Dude, get an air fryer. 15 minutes, bro. You can cook anything in 15 minutes in an air fryer, bro.
God, dude. What do you want this slow roasted potatoes, dog? Throw them in the microwave for 10 minutes. This should taste the same.
You can make anything in
just
an air fryer,
kid
bro.
Cuisine.
Bruh.
I hope they have like those big special like platter plates, you know, where they have the big lids and you lift them up and there's shit inside, like food, but then it's just
shit.
it's just literal shit.
Here you go. Thanks for cleaning the house, honey.
So I see here that we all kind of agree here. Oddly enough, though, this post was a very divisive one.
How?
Because it's Reddit.
What? Are you serious? How is this divided? Okay, I need to hear from the other side.
Yeah, it is one side.
Okay, so I'll be reading some of the posts.
Because we hate women.
Oh,
I'll be reading some of the comments.
Women belong in kitchen.
Yeah, women belong only in the kitchen.
This one says, not the asshole. You had an arrangement and she broke it. Everybody needs to pull their weight in a household. Was she expecting to do nothing at all?
Bruh.
Well, I don't know what the agreement was. We don't know.
Did they shake on it? Is there a contract?
Well, I mean, if it's been happening for 3 years.
Where's the NDA?
At the
NDA?
Very least, it's been unspoken, dog.
When the contract ends.
I honestly feel like she was having a bad day. I feel like we all have those days where we're kind of tired at everything, and sometimes we could like lash out. Not saying that's okay, but it happens. Just like talk to your partner.
Here's another comment. Not the asshole. She sounds like a lazy, entitled princess that wants everything
done
for her, so she can just spend all day doing nothing. If I'm a stay-at-home mom, and all I expected my husband to do is put his clothes into the hamper, trash in the trash can, and fix stuff that breaks and I don't know how to fix. I have a kid to look after and still have 2 meals a day ready. She has no excuse to behave that way.
I was wondering like what else she does in the day to make her like feel so fed up with
Sudoku.
I know the cooking, like if he really expects like gourmet meals that take 3 hours to prepare, that's
why
a lot.
Why do they need to take 3 hours, bro?
He tastes the food and it's like, this only tastes like it took 2 hours to prepare. What the f-?
You're sleeping in the backyard tonight.
2 hours, unacceptable.
I like the idea that this is actually Gordon Ramsay and he goes, hello, bro. Go try again.
This is not a 3 hour dinner.
Like the work should be comparatively even. Like it depends on what he does.
What is his job? just yeah. boring.
How hard is his job, homie? And he also has the whole inheritance yeah. bullshit.
Mate, so. I mean, you find out he works at fucking Blizzard, and he's a misogynist.
Hey, it's a stressful job.
Hey, Evan cuts him at work, and he's shredding evidence.
Honestly, this post would make sense if he did treat women poorly.
Hey, you know, something we didn't even consider is, like, there might be something wrong with their sex life, too. If they're getting
Where did that come from?
Well, I'm saying, if they're getting this angry...
He wants it 3 hours, not in the food. That's not what he was talking about.
Me, I'm horny, darling.
All you do is cook, and you never...
There's definitely something missing here.
And while that's going, I'll read you guys the final note on this post.
The final boss.
She came home. She cried. She apologized. Oh. I said it back too and hugged me.
Oh.
Told me she loved me. Said she didn't know what came into her. She said she acted like a C-U-N-T.
Oh.
She said she would cut off the friend. Toxic in many ways.
Whoa.
Never really liked her in the first place.
What?
And asked me to forgive her. She says she was just tired of being at home doing nothing.
See,
we'll talk about it later. We might be getting a pet.
I was thinking of the friend this whole time because earlier I was just making assumptions. Maybe the friend has, you know, her best interests at heart, but maybe the friend is jealous of their relationship, you know, because there are some friends out there that'll like try to twist your mind and be like, oh, hey, don't you think your relationship is like missing this or it's not this and that? So maybe it was just a friend, you know, we're assuming a
like
lot.
Like I said, I think it ends up on both of them. Like I think her, what she did was kind of wild.
Yeah.
But what he did was too. If those are your priorities in your relationship, that's fine. Everyone has set standards for their relationships. You gotta have some understanding.
But I'm thinking they should spice up their sex life.
Jen thinks this has been one long allusion to sex.
Wait, guys, by cooking and cleaning, they meant oral. We don't know how their sex life is, and I think that's a factor. That's just
Thank
me.
You, Jen.
It ain't
good. And everyone agrees. Well, not only one person does not think it's wrong. The 33 others do believe so. But that is it. Thank you guys for joining me. So that couple wasn't really trying to hear each other out. But if you're going to be tuning out a loved one, you might as well do it with some quality earbuds. Yes, this video is sponsored by Raycon. 10 out of 10 for the toxic relationship transition I did right there. Now, Raycons are my go-to Bluetooth earbuds. They're great for when you're on the go and just want some good tunes to listen to without, you know, the whole wires thing. I mean, I told y'all recently, I recently upgraded to a phone with no headphone jack, so it gave me the perfect excuse to start using my Raycons. And it's dope because the Bluetooth is seamless and it gives you a comfortable noise isolating fit so you can start listening right away, like right out the door. And the audio quality is amazing too, like comparable to what you get from other premium brands, except Raycon starts at half the price. Like, come on, this is a steal. Not to mention they offer a new rubber oil look and feel that is truly, truly slick and nice in the ears. And the optimized gel tips provide the perfect in-ear fit. Plus, the new everyday earbuds come with 3 new sound profiles to make sure everything you're listening to sounds its best with just the right amount of bass. Not to mention the 8 hours of play time, the 32-hour battery life. It's even got a built-in mic so you can take calls. Like, come on, y'all. And Raycons come with a 45-day happiness guarantee. So if you want an amazing deal and some amazing earbuds, go to buyraycon.com/CurtRichy today to get 20% off your next order of Raycon. So once again, that's buyraycon.com/CurtRichy to get 20% off your Raycons. Thank you so much for Raycon for sponsoring this video. Hey, ooh, what's up, y'all? Yo, thank you all so much for watching this video. It has been a very interesting one, to say the least. Also, I'd like to mention, I said this at the beginning of the video, but I will be going to Anime NYC. So please pull up to all 3 of my panels. It'll be a good time. Check the schedule and you'll see we'll be doing two for Crunchyroll and for Bot on Saturday. And on Sunday, I'll have 1 for Recreyo. Other than that, yo, much love for watching. Thank you so much to my patrons as usual. Join the Discord if you are, into that and you want to be a part of more discussions. And also, I've been working with Crunchyroll a lot, and I've been helping Crunchyroll Hime, the VTuber, with her streams. And she's really cool and gets upset a lot, and it's dope. So y'all should check that out too. Anyways, that's all I got. I guess I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.